I want to talk about my absolute favorite test to do on anyone who comes in the office. That's the CIMT test, also known as the carotid intima media thickness test. Now, the intima and media are two different layers inside of our blood vessels. The intima is the innermost layer of the blood vessel, and the media is the muscle layer in the middle. If our arteries thicken, or if we build plaque in our arteries, it occurs between those two layers of the blood vessel. I want to answer some common questions that I get from patients in this practice and talk about some other more well-known screening modalities, such as the calcium score and the carotid duplex, and how they stack up to the CIMT test. Now, my name is Zachary Lott. I'm a nurse practitioner, and I'm the founding partner at Nexus Healthspan. Together with my physician colleague, Dr. Lily Johnston, who's a vascular surgeon by training, specialize in heart attack, stroke, and metabolic disease prevention. We incorporate bioidentical hormone replacement therapy into our practice, and I like to treat what I refer to as the canary in the coal mine for men's cardiovascular disease, which is erectile dysfunction. Now, to talk about the CIMT test, I break it down into two important components. The first, and what I would argue would be the most important initial finding, would be really answering the yes or no question, do you have plaque in your arteries? It's the mere presence of plaque that is one of our most prognostic or predictive metrics for someone's 10-year risk for having a heart attack or a stroke. The other side of that would be the IMT value, which is the other important component of the CIMT test. The IMT value is derived from hundreds of measurements of the common carotid artery, and it's a number that is very precise, very reproducible, and can be used as a tool over time to monitor disease progression or regression in patients and let us know is what you're doing for your body actually working. Now, one important thing to know about the CIMT laboratories that grade and report these exams is not all labs are created equal. There's one lab that I use, and it's called CardioRisk Laboratories. And they have the best standards for precision and reproducibility and really set the bar for not just the whole country, but the entire world for how this test should be done. And we owe those standards to their owner, Dr. Todd Eldridge, who's an engineer by background and has a PhD in cardiovascular epidemiology and has more experience with ultrasound than anybody I've ever known. And so thanks, Todd. We owe a lot to you for what you've been able to do with CardioRisk Labs. Now, when we do a CIMT full protocol, the lab will take measurements of the peak areas looking at essentially plaque. And we define plaque as thickening in the artery wall of 1.3 millimeters or greater. And then they use over 600 measurements to determine the average thickness of your blood vessels, which is used to calculate your arterial age. And so this becomes very important over time because if we see a change in as little as 1 or 2 hundredths of a millimeter, that's actual real change. And so it becomes a very powerful monitoring tool to look at people annually to see, are your arteries thickening? Have we halted the progression? I'm an overachiever and I like to see arterial age reverse. So we can actually reverse some of the impacts of cardiovascular disease. Now, the presence of plaque is probably the greatest value we get from an initial exam. And we base that from some research that was done over 20 years ago. There was this research study published in the medical journal Circulation called the CAFE's CAVE study. And this study looked at over 13,000 people. And this was a generally healthy population, normal cholesterol, normal blood pressure, normal blood sugar. I think there were some smokers in this study, but it was a pretty good representation of a healthy population. What they did in this study was at the baseline of the study, they did ultrasounds on everybody. And they looked at the common carotid arteries and the femoral arteries in the groin. And based off of what they saw there, no matter what it was, the rule for the study was, well, you don't get to do anything about it. We're just going to watch you for the next decade. So after 10,000 people had completed 10 years in the research study, that's when they published the data. And what we found was in a perfectly normal exam, it's like a 1 in 10,000 chance of having a heart attack, very low. If you had some thickening in the arteries, that rose the risk to about 9%. If we started to develop plaque, so long as it was non-stenosing or non-flow obstructing, less than 50%, which is where most people who have plaque fall in, call it class 3 arterial disease, that's associated with a 39% 10-year risk of having a heart attack or a stroke. That's a big number that most people can grasp onto. And an important thing to note is at 39% 10-year risk is if you are left untreated. And the silver lining here is if we find disease in someone's arteries, there's a lot we can do about it, from a treatment, prevention, from progression of disease, and even some degree of reversal. Then when we get into class four, which is the highest risk group, that's having a plaque that is flow obstructive or greater than 50% stenosis. That's associated with about an 81% 10-year risk of heart attack or stroke if left untreated. So this is really valuable information. And this is information I obtain on every single person who comes into this office, whether we're doing a full CIMT protocol or they're just here for an initial new patient consultation, because that information will change what we do starting day one. Now, another ultrasound that is very commonly done and mistaken for the CIMT is a test called the carotid duplex. And what a carotid duplex is it's a simple study of blood flow up to the brain. And so long as there's no occlusive plaque, it'll get called normal. So someone can have a plaque that's creates a 30% stenosis inside of the artery, but the exam gets called normal because it's not obstructing flow to the brain. But we know that a plaque that size is associated with an almost 40% 10-year risk for heart attack or stroke. So although the carotid duplex might be called normal, doing a CIMT test tells us, well, that's very abnormal and we need to do something about it. Otherwise, we know what happens if we don't treat it. Another common question I get is about the coronary artery calcium score, which is a great test. It certainly has its utility, but it has its a big blind spot. So the biggest limitation with a coronary artery calcium score is that it does not see soft plaque, which is the higher risk, more dangerous plaque. And it takes some time after someone develops plaque in their arteries for it to go from soft plaque to more stable calcified plaque. So the CT scan, which uses X-ray technology, which requires some density to bounce the X-rays off to create an image, it can only see the calcified plaque that's been there long enough to have calcified. And an important part of the calcium score is in men under 50 and women under 65, the calcium score misses disease 80 to 85% of the time. So that's a big limitation. So when we look at a coronary artery calcium score report, if I have a 50-year-old man who has a calcium score of zero, all that tells me for sure is he doesn't have calcified plaque in the coronary arteries, but could still have soft plaque elsewhere. And so that's, again, another value of the ultrasound is we can see soft plaque right away. And so when we go through the CIMT test protocol, we're able to look at plaque, take measurements, and the lab reports those and reports the characteristic of the plaque, confirming whether it's soft, mixed plaque, or calcified plaque. Because the characteristic of the plaque plays an important role in really helping determine someone's overall risk. As far as other limitations from the calcium score or things that I typically will advise against is if you've had a positive calcium score, I advise against getting another one. We know that over time, especially with optimal medical therapy, that plaque will calcify and that calcium score number will increase. And in my experience, the stress of seeing an increased calcium score isn't worth getting the test again, because a repeat calcium score does not change management recommendations. Whereas when we look at the IMT value over time from the CIMT test, we can see with a great degree of precision if there's been any change in the average thickness of the blood vessels, which that is a very actionable thing, because if arteries are thickening too rapidly, then we know that's associated with a much greater increased risk, and we know we need to step our game up somewhere. We can also see if it's at a standstill year over year or if we're reversing it. Now, how we do the scans in our office, it's not just you come in, get a scan and leave. I like to sit down with people, talk about their medical history, talk about their family medical history, what medications you might be taking. I like reviewing labs if someone's previously had labs done in the last year or so, especially if it's looking at inflammation markers or lipids, cholesterol, or blood sugar metrics, because those are all important players in figuring out, well, why did you as an individual develop plaque in your arteries? So typically we ask people if they've got labs, bring them in with them, plan on about an hour long appointment. Although the exam only takes about 20 minutes, depending on how much I'm running my mouth. I like to afford time to both review someone's history and then also after the exam, review all the images that I'll be sending off to the lab afterwards. So we get to see all the images that we took. We get to see what's the thickness of your arteries look like. If you have plaque, what's the characteristic like? How much is there? And then we send those images off to CardioRisk and they turn around a report in about a week, which we send to you via email. Now there's a number of patients who they find us online because we do the CIMT test. Our office has only two of a couple providers on the whole West Coast that do this themselves. And some of the patients that come in find that we were the people that they were looking for from a prevention aspect as well. So sometimes if we see things like plaque on the CIMT test, someone will ask if we can order labs and then take them on as a patient or either collaborate with their primary care provider or their cardiologist in their overall treatment plan. So in summary, the CIMT test is a great evaluation of the health of the lining of the blood vessels and helps us see both the presence of plaque and the characteristic of plaque. We're capable of doing a lot of things to help from a prevention standpoint. And all in all, we take a much more holistic approach, focusing on not just keeping people alive, but keeping people well. We're concerned about health span. And really, we probably advise and recommend more things that don't require a prescription than we do recommend drugs. And it's really important that whatever someone does from a prevention standpoint, that really the focus is on a foundation of proper nutrition, proper sleep, exercise. And one thing that surprises a lot of people is the health of their teeth. And so we take a deep dive into all this stuff with our patients to better get to the reason as to why. Why has there been a problem or a change in your arterial health? Because if we have a why, then we have a target to go after and something to treat so that we can prevent things from progressing. And ultimately, the goal is to prevent a heart attack and to prevent a stroke.